This video will provide instructions on installing and getting started with GenomeBrowse. If you're a Mac user, you will only have one download option. If you're a PC user and not sure whether to download 32-bit or 64-bit, go to the Start menu, open File Explorer, go to This PC, select Computer, select Properties. My computer is operating on 64-bit, so I will download 64-bit version. If you're operating on 32-bit, then you should download the 32-bit version. Once a download is complete, click Show in Folder. Initiate the installation, click Next, and check the box to create a desktop icon. Then select Next, and click Install. When the installation is complete, uncheck the box to launch GenomeBrowse, and then click Finish. We're gonna take a look at our desktop, drag the GenomeBrowse icon onto your taskbar, and then delete the GenomeBrowse desktop icon. Also, go to your Downloads folder and delete the GenomeBrowse installer. Launch GenomeBrowse. You'll have to register an account with Golden Helix. Once you do, type in your password and log in. Click No on this window, then click Add. We are going to download a few files to our computer. Go to Public Annotations, then Assembly. Select these two files. We'll explain their importance later. Then click Download. Then go to Genes and Regulations and select RefSeq Genes 63 UCSC. Then click Download. Next, go to Variations and Functions and look for dbSNP 144 NCBI. Then click Download. You can observe your download progress in the download window. It may threaten to take a few hours, but my installation only took about 45 minutes. During that time, I got myself some lunch and cleaned my desk. Just saying. I'm going to skip to the end. Once the downloads are complete, go to User Annotations, right-click on one of these files, and select Show in Folder. Let's minimize this for now. We'll use it again in a minute. Next, let's go to the link provided in the description. Awesome. Now we want the FarmGKB missense variants and FarmGKB variants files. So let's go ahead and right-click on these files and select Download. Once the downloads are complete, click Show in Folder. And now let's also open up the Annotations folder and drag the two FarmGKB files into the Annotations folder. Now, we'll have to restart GenomeBrowse for it to recognize the new files. Now let's go back to Add, and you'll see the two FarmGKB files have been added. So let's go ahead and make sure these new files we downloaded are working. Select Plot and Close, and you'll see that they do show up. We'll learn how to analyze this information later. For now, go ahead and hide the tracks by unchecking these boxes. Good job.